But first, circular design. And then it's important, I think, to explain what I mean with circular design, because there's then when you look at circular economy, there is about 107 different definitions. That's what I call science. And I won't add another definition, but I do want to describe what I consider the main aspects. And the bottom line is sustainability, people, planet, and prosperity. I don't consider circular economy a goal in itself. It's really a means to become sustainable in a viable way. And but in my view, distinguishes design for a circular economy from, for instance, eco-design is its focus on that viability and even the potential to lead to attractive business propositions. Basically, what this slide shows is what we do in a linear economy, taking materials, making a product, using the product, disposing it. Part goes to waste, part is recycled, but what we do recycle is, from a design perspective, coincidental. Usually we didn't apply any design for recycling, and we might have mixed materials that are recyclable in such a way that they still cannot be recovered at end of life. So recycling is done, but can be much improved when we take design for recycling into account. Both products consist of the same type of functional components, and you will largely see the same type of modules. But what is completely different is the way in which those modules are connected. In the way of the Fairphone, the modules are made in such a way that they are all connected with standard screws, and you just need a single screwdriver to be able to loosen all those. Whereas in the case of the iPhone, still also internally, glue has been used. Some components have been soldered, and in some cases, proprietary screws have been used. So when it comes to self-repair, it's quite clear that Fairphone really has enabled this. Whereas in the case of the iPhone, it basically is almost blocked. Does that make the Fairphone indeed the more sustainable one? Here you see an example of bikes that were in a bike service. And in some cases, cities are flooded with low quality bikes for bike sharing schemes in order, for instance, to achieve a large market share. And after a limited number of shares already, they have obtained a profit margin and they don't care if the bikes are then disposed or not. And that results in a huge disposal of bikes really prematurely. So this illustrates that just having such a service in place is not sufficient. You also have to think about what happens with the product after the product has fulfilled its service life. Circular economy is disruptive. It should really, in my view, focus on sustainability. It's not a goal in itself. And then there is a number of things related to the integrity of products that need to be taken into account. And the things at the left hand right, I think I addressed a number of them. On the right hand side, the aspects related to the value chain, setting up new collaborative structures, ways to affect and interact with users, and new policies, regulations, are also things that will deserve attention.